oh man, the Seahawks finally had a solid game all around. The offense scored some touchdowns, didn't have turnovers. The defense played actual defense. Man, a solid all-around game and a solid victory over a tough opponent. We're not going to be talking about this play, because, but let's just get right into the video. Before we actually do get into the video, I just want to mention something real quick, and that's because I got this comment. Honestly, I'm not mad at it because this is kind of a compliment, but when I look at this comment, I'm pretty sure he's saying that I'm reading off of like an article or something and just kind of putting it as a video, but I'm not. When I make the preview videos and the recap videos, I just have the stats on hand as reference, and really that's it. Everything else is just coming from my thoughts on what can happen and my reactions to what actually happened in the game for the recaps and the previews. So honestly, I just saw this comment. And, I wanted to talk about it a little bit because, honestly, I think it's a compliment because he's kind of assuming that I'm reading off of something, which kind of means I'm doing a good job. All right, what's up, everyone? I'm Faloki, and today we're going to be taking a look at a recap of the matchup between the now 7-3 Seattle Seahawks and the now 6-4 Arizona Cardinals. Like I said in the beginning of the video, this was definitely a very solid victory all around for the Seahawks over a tough Cardinals team. And honestly, our defense, surprisingly enough, came out and actually played defense. They held the Cardinals to just over 100 yards in the first half. Being the best team and actually gaining yards, especially in the run game, it was very surprising to see our defense actually stop this team and hold them to 100 total yards, and I believe around 25, 26 rushing yards in the first half. The only thing I was really disappointed with in the first half was our offense. Even though our offense played a really clean half, they threw 2 touchdowns. We did miss an extra point, but really no turnovers. We got a couple touchdowns, not a bad first half. I would have liked to see us score a little bit more, take more advantage of our defense actually playing well, get a big lead, but we didn't really end up doing that. We only went up by 9 points at halftime. After holding the Cardinals to just 7 points in the first half, in the second half, our defense still played pretty well, holding them to just 14 points, which is honestly surprising for our defense. They did have a really good game overall. We had a couple nice sacks. We did have some really bad plays, but we also had some good plays to make up for it. We let up a wide open touchdown like you saw in the beginning of the video, but overall, I mean, that's one mess up. We had a couple missed tackles, but honestly, just a very good game for our defense, and our offense was able to continue to score even when the Cardinals were scoring, to continue to hold our lead. And honestly, we just played a good all-around game. This is a game that I like to see. You know, I don't like to see us winning 35-32 because we're putting up points, which is nice, but our defense just isn't playing well. To see our defense actually play well and our offense play really solid, you know, this is just a good game. The way this game went gives me a little bit of hope for the Seahawks going into the future, and that's because our time of possession was really good. We had 35 minutes of time of possession to the Cardinals 25 minutes, and honestly, this was just a good game. We got the run game going. Carlos Hyde played very well. We had Bo Scarborough come in. He had a couple nice plays. He got injured though. DJ Dallas, when he was given the ball, he made the most of his opportunities. Honestly, our run game, our running backs were doing a lot. They were doing really well. And I am very excited to have Chris Carson back, because if Carlos Hyde can do this good against such a good defense, imagine what Chris Carson can do throughout the next like 5 to 8 games of pretty easy opponents. But now to take a look at the stats for this game, Russell Wilson played really solid, completing 23 of his 28 passing attempts for 197 yards, 2 touchdowns, no interceptions. Just a solid day, pretty efficient, completing most of his passes. Didn't really need too many yards because our run game did so well. And Kyler Murray, on the other hand, playing from behind most of the game, and their run game really never got going. He threw the ball 42 times, completed 29 of them for 269 yards and 2 touchdowns, no interceptions. And when it comes to the run game, the Seahawks completely outplayed the Cardinals there with 31 rushes for 165 yards and a touchdown, averaging over 5 yards per carry. And the Cardinals ran the ball 18 times for 57 yards and a touchdown, just over 3 yards per carry. So definitely the Seahawks running game got going, and it really helped us on the offense and just in the entire game. Defensively, both teams had 3 sacks, and honestly, both defenses played pretty well. It was really just a matter of the Cardinals giving up a couple more plays than the Seahawks defense gave up. So honestly, good win for the Seahawks and a good game by the Seahawks defense. Probably the first good game that we've had all season. But away from the stats and all that, this was definitely a game of penalties for both teams. There were 18 total penalties called for almost 200 yards. And honestly, watching this game, it was just kind of funny. There were a lot of false starts, there were a lot of holding calls, and there were just a lot of dumb penalties that were being committed by both teams. One of the main series of penalties was early on in the first quarter. The Cardinals had the ball. Kyler Murray had an intentional grounding call, which then led the Cardinals to be on the 1-yard line, and there was a holding in the end zone, which led to a safety, which honestly was just funny. That's kind of how the whole game went. It was just penalty after penalty after penalty. The Seahawks had a couple bad penalties where they could have had a 3-and-out. They could have been making big defensive plays, but you know, there was a horse collar tackle on Bobby Wagner. Quandre Diggs had an unnecessary roughness on a 3rd down, which was an incomplete pass that would have just been a three and out. But honestly, you know, definitely a game of penalties. But I mean, the Seahawks overcame. They had two less penalties than the Cardinals did. So, you know, overall, game of penalties, Seahawks did fine. In the beginning of the video, I did say that we weren't going to be looking at these three plays, but I do want to look at just two of these plays, and that is the DK Metcalf drop and the wide open touchdown for the Cardinals. First, the DK Metcalf drop. This one was just really disappointing because this should have been an easy catch, but DK Metcalf ended up dropping it, just didn't get his hands up in time, and that would have given us a touchdown. We ended up getting a field goal before halftime, but that would have been a very nice touchdown to close out the half. Would have given us a lot of momentum, would have given us a pretty solid lead, but just didn't happen. DK Metcalf didn't catch the ball. Very unfortunate, but overall, it was something that we overcame. We still won the game. Not too big of a problem. And the second one, the wide open touchdown for the Cardinals. Honestly, I just didn't like this play because it was pretty obvious that they were going to pass the ball. I'm pretty sure it was third down and like two to go for a touchdown. And our defense decided to go for an all-out blitz and not cover the entire left side of the field for some reason, even though, you know, yes, they did have three people on the left side of the field, but there's going to be at least one of them doing a crossing route. Just really dumb play, especially since Jamal Adams really didn't rush. He kind of ran to the offensive line, stood there, didn't go back and cover a man. Just overall not a good play by our defense, not a great, you know, play draw up. And, you know, some player could have at least turned around and kind of realized that the entire left side of the field was open, but no one really did. Just a wide open touchdown, probably the easiest touchdown I've seen all season. But even with these two big mistakes, we still found a way to win the game. They didn't really hurt us too bad. Of course, the DK Metcalf touchdown would have definitely put us in a better spot, given us a better lead, more momentum going into halftime. And honestly, our defensive play there, where we let up a wide open pass to Chase Edmonds, we could have done a lot better on that play. Could have at least played some defense. We probably still would have given up a touchdown there because it was third and goal on around the 3 yard line. But still, we could have played at least better defense, at least had someone on the left side of the field. So that was just completely a blown defensive play. And maybe even if we got that stop, we would have held them to a field goal. That would have been a lot better situation for us overall going into the end of the game. But either way, I mean, we did make those two mistakes, but we ended up winning the game. We had a really nice defensive play at the end of the game by Carlos Dunlap, our new acquisition a couple weeks ago. Made an amazing sack on fourth down, just absolutely sealed the deal. Amazing play by him. And honestly, I was surprised that our defense played this well against the number one offense in the league. I'm not going to get my hopes up and say that our defense has figured it out, because I don't really think we have. It's pretty obvious that we had some really bad plays, some really bad coverages. But overall, the last 2 weeks, we stopped the Rams from scoring, but that was just a bad game. But this week, I'm very surprised, very pleasantly surprised by our defense actually stopping this amazing Cardinals team. We stopped the run game, which is the best in the NFL, to only 57 yards, less than 4 yards a carry. We stopped DeAndre Hopkins. He really didn't get involved. Trey Flowers, although we did give up some easy passes, I did see him have some pretty good coverage on DeAndre Hopkins some plays. And honestly, Trey Flowers and BJ Reed, for being the third and fourth string cornerbacks, to be able to guard DeAndre Hopkins and the other talented receivers on that Cardinals team for as well as they did, definitely just good on them. That was very good defense by them. Even though they did give up plays, they made some plays too. They played some good coverage, you know, didn't let them get open sometimes, but of course they're good wide receivers. They're going to get open eventually. But overall, our defense played well. Carlos Dunlap had two sacks. He had the game winning sack. LJ Collier, I believe, was the person who ended up forcing the hold inside the end zone to give the Seahawks a safety on the Cardinals. So overall, our defense played really well. We surprisingly made plays on defense, didn't get any interceptions or any turnovers or anything like that. And honestly, I'm glad that our defense played this way, because, you know, sometimes our defense played well early on in the season, but it was really because we forced a couple turnovers, some interceptions. And today we really just came out, we made stops. And that was nice to see, because, you know, our defense is good when they can get turnovers, but if your defense can get stops and let their offense only score 21 points for a team that's been letting up like 30, 40 points a game without any turnovers to win the game and have that many good stops, I'm very proud of this defense. I'm not going to get hopeful and say that we're going to be doing this for the rest of the season, but we've got some pretty easy games going up for the next few weeks. And I'm pretty excited to see how those go. Offensively for the Seahawks, just a very solid game. Russell Wilson came out, played efficient, didn't have any interceptions, didn't have any turnovers, threw some touchdowns. A really good game for him. The run game got going. Carlos Hyde played well. He came in, he just did what our run game couldn't do the past few weeks with him and Chris Carson gone. And it was really nice to see. You know, you really don't see too many fans excited over 4 or 5 yard rushes. But man, was I happy to see those 4 or 5 yard rushes from Carlos Hyde, because we had not been seeing them. You know, without Carlos Hyde, those rushes where Carlos Hyde pushed the pile and kind of went forward for a couple more yards, got 4 or 5 yards on a play, those probably would have been negative yardage plays, with, you know, Travis Homer and DJ Dallas. And that's nothing against those two guys. It's just the fact that really they don't push as hard as Carlos Hyde and Chris Carson can. But man, it was nice to see the run game get going. It made it a lot easier for Russell Wilson. And probably one of the best plays that we had this game was on a 3rd and 18, 3rd and 17, something like that, where Russell Wilson scrambled out and just threw the ball out around the end of the game and let us get a field goal. Didn't try to force anything, didn't throw an interception, and it ended up leading us to the win. Of course, we probably would have got the win either way without it because we stopped the Cardinals on defense, but it definitely put us in a better situation to at least go to overtime if our defense couldn't stop them. But it was just really nice today to see Russell Wilson not feel like he had to force anything because our run game got going. Overall, just a really good offensive game, really good defensive game for the Seahawks, a great all-around game for the Seahawks today, and honestly, probably one of the best games you had all season, even if it was one of our lower scoring games. But overall, this was definitely a very solid game for the Seahawks all around, but I'm not going to get too hopeful. We have some pretty easy games going on for the next few weeks, and honestly, I'm very excited to watch our offense do a little bit better, get some more highlight plays, watch our defense hopefully continue to just pick up the pace, play how they did today against some worse teams, get some interceptions, get some turnovers, just stop them, maybe hold a team under 20 points for once. That'd be nice to see, but honestly, I'm excited for the next few games. I'm not going to be too hopeful. I'm not going to be saying that our defense is going to be the best defense in the league for the next however long for the rest of the season, but I am hopeful. I am hopeful that our offense will get going again, our run game with Chris Carson and Carlos Hyde being back next week, because Chris Carson probably will be back next week. This is going to be exciting. It's going to be nice to have a real run game, have the offense just about fully healthy, have the defense hopefully healthy enough and actually playing well. I'm excited for the next few games. I'm not going to say that we're going to be a great defense. Our defense still needs to really prove themselves. It's been one game, like a game and a half, because that Rams game, the defense was all right. But we still need to prove ourselves defensively, and our defense continues to make some mistakes. We need to fix those mistakes up, honestly, and continue to play better. But our offense did fine. It was nice to have a run game. Our defense did really good today. Overall, just a really good win for the Seahawks, and I'm definitely excited for our next few games. But with that, that's going to do it for this video. Let me know down below what you thought of this game. I was pleasantly surprised by our defense, and I was glad that our run game could get going like I thought it would with Carlos Hyde back. I'm excited to have Chris Carson back, but like I said, let me know down below in the comments what you think. With that, I'd like to thank you for watching. Make sure to leave a like if you enjoyed, subscribe if you're new. Have a great day.